everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Priya Mistry, and I'm a general dentist whose practice is focused on taking care of patients with TMJ disorders. Today's video is part two of jaw locked closed. So part two of talking about what I commonly call in our practice a closed lock, where the jaw can barely open more than one or two finger widths, and it's incredibly painful for the person going through it. So first and foremost, we're going to discuss how we treat these patients in our office. Then I want to go into what you guys can do, you general dentists can do in your office to provide some care and relief to these patients. And lastly, I want to discuss which patients experience this most often and why. So in our office, what we do to treat these patients is we make custom-made mouthpieces. We call them orthotics. So it's really about aligning the jaw in three-dimensional space to allow for optimal healing. So we measure where the muscles are most relaxed, their correct resting length, and where the joints are aligned, and we build custom-made mouthpieces to that position. We ask patients to wear them at all times unless they're eating or drinking anything but water. And along with that, we do our own specialized physical therapy, and we do our own very specialized jaw manipulation. So there's a very sensitive technique to those last two with the physical therapy and the jaw manipulation that it took me a better part of a year to learn, and we're able to get our patients excellent results. If this condition occurred within the last 6 months, we consider that acute. So it's still new, meaning we have a better chance at resolving it. So if it occurred within the last 6 months, we tell our patients we can get the disc back where it's supposed to be and stable, usually within 4 to 6 months. The way we treat these patients is we see them every week once we deliver the orthotics to them for our own physical therapy, for jaw manipulation, or for checking the orthotics. Then as their symptoms get better and better, we see them every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, every 4 weeks until we can release them from treatment. For more chronic cases that have been going on for longer than 6 months, so somebody locked off the disc 10 months ago and they didn't know where to go, it took them that long to find us, or whatever it may be, for whatever reason that they didn't get in here like sooner to see us immediately. Those patients, it's really difficult to tell when the disc will unlock. So what happens in a chronic case is that the retrodiscal tissue, which is compressed between the two bony components of the joint in a locked joint, starts to act as a pseudo disc. This is our body trying to compensate. It tries to pretend it's the disc. And all this time, the disc is still dislocated. And the longer the disc is dislocated and in the wrong position, the more it starts to change shape. So it goes from a biconcave shape to an oval shape, and it becomes more of a barrier to opening. Our bodies are amazing, and they can compensate. And so once the pseudo disc is formed, what happens is that the patients are usually able to open a little bit more, but not to their full maximum capacity. So to put it in perspective, with a full opening, we should all be able to open 45 to 50 millimeters when you're measuring edge to edge from the top teeth to the bottom teeth. In a locked situation that is acute, we find that these patients can open 25 millimeters or less. In a locked situation where it's chronic, we find that these patients have adapted and can maybe open 35 millimeters or so. So they've gained back some range of motion, but definitely not their full range of motion, and they're typically still in pain. So this is not a situation that you want to let go for too long, because there's a certain window of opportunity where we can really get in there and make things right and give you a time frame for how long that will take. We have certainly treated patients that are chronically locked, but it's taken me anywhere from maybe 6 to 9 months or so to get them unlocked and stable. And even then, they have a lower chance of regaining as much range of motion as those people that come in when they're acutely locked. But essentially, they have their quality of life back. They don't have pain anymore, no pain with yawning, chewing. They can open a lot bigger. They can eat a big sandwich. And so at the end of the day, it comes down to quality of life. But we're typically able to get all of our patients very, very good results. General dentists, what can you do in your practice? So there's a list of do's and a list of don'ts. Let's start with the do's. So do prescribe your patient Flexeril or Advil if they're in severe pain. And you'll know when these patients are not comfortable. We're able to read people's pain levels pretty quickly as dentists, and Flexeril and Advil can just help relieve that. I typically put my patients on about a 10-day regimen of that, but I ask them to make sure they return for treatment ASAP because I can't keep prescribing those. Another thing to do is have these aqualizers handy. These things are amazing, and I wish I had invented them. So what they have is two pads that are filled with sterile water. And these pads, when they rest between the top and bottom teeth in the back on both sides, they serve as a waterbed for the muscles in your head, neck, and jaw. And it can really help with headaches, jaw pain, and ear pain associated with this condition. It won't typically get the patient unlocked, unfortunately. That requires more, such as jaw manipulation and physical therapy. But it can really help with their quality of life in the short term. I have seen this get one patient unlocked. They didn't stay unlocked, but it was pretty neat that it was able to do that for that one patient. Another thing you want to do is make sure you can recognize what's going on. So the five main signs and symptoms that go along with this, as I listed in part one of this series, know them forwards and backwards and be able to identify them. Have this little scale handy so that you can measure how much your patients can open, and also the right and left measurements as well. It's so important to have this handy and with you. Don'ts. So do not try to force the jaw open. That can be incredibly painful and incredibly ineffective. It's not going to work unless the muscles are relaxed with some very specific physical therapy to some very specific muscles. The other don't is don't make a night guard that replicates their natural bite. This was my go-to solution for everything when I practiced general dentistry for 11 years, and I know it ended up doing more harm than good to some of these patients because I just didn't know better. So I'm not trying to shame, I'm not trying to make anybody feel bad, I'm just trying to get knowledge out there. Definitely do not make a night guard that duplicates their original bite, because a problem in their bite could be what got them locked in the first place. So we don't want to go that route. The last thing I was going to discuss in this video was which patients this happens most commonly in and why. So this most commonly happens in women. And the reason for this is hormones. So the jaw joint has a ton of connective tissue in it. And this connective tissue is highly under the influence of hormones, particularly beta estradiol and relaxin. Both of these are found predominantly in women and at much higher levels in women. Beta estradiol and relaxin have been linked to degenerative problems and changes in the joint, so they actually can cause those. And relaxin also makes it so that ligaments are looser. So the ligaments that are holding the disc and helping it remain where it's supposed to remain, if they get looser, that disc has a higher probability of dislocating or not being where it's supposed to be. So in my practice, I have been working here for about 2 years, and in that time, every week there's 2 to 4 patients that come in with their jaws locked closed. And I don't know what the math is there, but out of all those patients that I've seen that have come in with their jaws locked closed, only 2 have been men. And both of these men had some hyperflexibility going on as well, and they were kind of aware of that. So it's predominantly a condition that occurs in women. And for women that are watching, that are going through this, we have a high pain tolerance and we tend not to complain. But if you're going through this, seek help. There is help for this. General dentist, one last tip is find a TMJ specialist in your area. Make a connection with them, have a good relationship with them, find out what methods they're using for this condition, and, you know, increase your knowledge base. It's so important to be able to help all of our patients that walk through our doors. So thank you so much for listening. If you liked what you heard, please click like below, subscribe to my channel. There's so much more to come, and I'm so excited to share it with you guys. Thank you.